The Singapore River houses some of the most important buildings in Singapore that are admired by tourists around the world. The Fullerton Hotel, Victoria Concert Hall, and Asian Civilizations Museum. But what made these buildings so iconic to Singapore? Have they always been this way? Let's take a journey back in time and delve deep into the history behind these structures. Dubbed the most important post office in the East by Joseph Conrad, the Fullerton is a monument of our time, a landmark of modern ingenuity and wealth. In the 1900s, it housed the Inland Revenue Department to supervise Singapore's industrialization plans and steered onto a path of modernization. Fullerton was regarded as the hub of commerce, being the center of Singapore's revenue-driving force since it housed the General Post Office until 1996. Letters were the main form of communication then, and this was Singapore's connection to the global market. Its importance and location by the Singapore River gave way to a 5-star luxury hotel where the rich relax and dine. Having witnessed the country's evolution through the years, the Fullerton Hotel has gained much sentimental and historical value. Generations remember going to this very building to post parcels and letters to family and relatives overseas. The building is not only a place of grandeur, but also one of memories and history. The Singapore River, being the center of Singapore's revenue and development, gave rise to multiple administrative departments helping to run the nation. The Empress Place Building housed the Immigration Department, which was remembered by many citizens of Singapore. Presently, it is transformed into the Asian Civilization Museum, the only museum that focuses on Asia's relationships with the outside world. They explore this via Singapore's bustling international port. Through a collection of articles left by traders from the past, the ACM is able to document the history and customs of Asia. It possesses significant value towards our rich past, from which there is much to learn even till this day. This helps to promote a public consensus about our roots and is important in educating future generations to come. Being known for its mesmerizing performances by the Singapore Symphony Orchestra, what used to be known as the Victoria Memorial Hall is now called the Victoria Concert Hall, and it hides a much deeper past, having been a key location in the shaping of Singapore's political scene. In 1948, election officials were briefed along with ballot paper counting here. Not only was the PAP's inaugural held here, but also meetings by the Rendell Commission. The place has since changed from an office to a place of entertainment. At first glance, these changes seem to be superficial, but that is not the case. When tourists come from far and wide to visit Singapore's iconic river, the Fullerton imprints a concept of wealth and success. These buildings allow us a passage back in time to appreciate how far we have come. While change shows development, continuity shows how their value remains as they become relics of our history. No matter how advanced we become, we can never go back to the past, and these pieces of colonial architecture are the last few fragments of Singapore's growth from a colonial to an independent nation. Such are the buildings which hold priceless value.